When you begin breeding isopods, it's not uncommon to find a death or an abnormal isopod and not know the causes. In this video, I will discuss the most common isopod problems and how to fix them. Like all invertebrates, isopods have to molt in order to grow, and they do this in halves. One half of the body will shed, and once that hardens, the other half of the body will also shed. This whole process is usually finished within minutes, but sometimes complications occur and the isopod may never complete its molt due to it getting stuck. Stuck exuvium can be fatal and usually causes a very slow death. If the front half of the exuvium gets stuck, the isopod will not be able to eat and will lose its ability to use the first few pairs of legs. Because of this, they will frequently be seen walking backwards. Isopods in this situation will slowly starve to death. If the back half of the exuvium gets stuck, the isopod may suffocate. Being crustaceans, isopods acquire oxygen with gills. These are thin membranous areas on the underside of the body. In order to function, the gills require continuous wetting. Isopods contain tail-like structures called uropods that help them acquire moisture. The uropods are able to wick up water, allowing them to moisten the gills, and also gives the isopod the ability to drink water from both ends of the body. In other words, isopods can drink water from their butts. Sometimes only one small segment of the exuvium may get stuck. If this piece is not removed, any future molts will continuously get stuck in this location, resulting in the isopod eventually getting strangled to death. So what causes stuck shed? Usually, if an isopod is having trouble molting, it's because the environment that it is living in is not humid enough. Your enclosure may have too much ventilation and/or not enough moisture. Molting troubles can also mean that your isopods are lacking calcium. So be sure to always have a calcium source available for your isopods. Thanks to selective breeding, terrestrial isopods can come in many different coloured morphs, ranging from grey to white and even to bright orange. Sometimes you may also find a very bright blue isopod, but as exciting as this may seem, this coloration has nothing to do with the color morph and has everything to do with a lethal virus that literally crystallizes isopods to death. This virus is called Iridiovirus, otherwise known as invertebrate iridescent virus 31. This virus is 100% fatal. Once the isopod has the intense blue colour as the specimens in this video, they will only live for another week or two. Not much is known about this virus, but if any of your isopods begin to turn blue or purple, I suggest removing them from all the other isopods so that it does not spread to any other individuals. Speaking of different colours, you may also come across an isopod that has one very white limb compared to the rest. But do not fear. This is just simply a newly regenerated piece of the body that was previously lost due to an injury. Like other invertebrates, if an isopod loses a leg or an antennae, they are able to grow a new one when they molt. The newly regenerated limb will get its normal coloration when the isopod completes ecdysis again. But if you come across an isopod that appears to have a big yellow blob inside their body, don't be surprised when that isopod dies, because it's most likely infected with Rhinophoridae larvae. The female woodlouse fly deposits her eggs on substrates contaminated by uropod gland secretions of isopods. This secretion is not commonly observed in all woodlice species, but it is rather easily obtained from Pusalio scaba, which may explain why this species is most commonly infected. The eggs deposited on the soil hatch, and the first insta larva attaches itself to the body of a passing woodlouse. After the larva has entered the host through the sternites, it then molts to its second insta and starts feeding, first on the hemolymph and then on the organs of the host. The third insta larva fills most of the body cavity, leading to isopod death. Pupation then occurs inside the empty exoskeleton of the host. Nothing can be done to save already infected woodlouse, but you can save the rest of the uninfected by doing these steps. Step 1. Hang yellow sticky fly tape around your isopod enclosures to attract and catch any adult woodlouse flies. Step 2. Sort through all of your isopods and remove any that you can see that are infected. If the larvae are big enough, you will be able to see the yellowish body inside the isopod. These infected should be humanely euthanized. And step 3, remove all of the substrate and replace with brand new substrate. Make sure you aren't adding any wild isopods into your colonies without quarantining them first and observing their health. And that finishes up this video about the common isopod problems and their solutions. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on our next video, which will be all about sudden colony crashes and why they are